If you're an ActionVFX user that works primarily in Adobe After Effects, and you want to get the most out of all of your ActionVFX assets, this video is for you. Hey guys, it's Sam from ActionVFX. And in this video, we're gonna look at our assets that are in the Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4 color space, and how you can take them from that color space and composite them in a Rec 709 preview while retaining all of the data. If you don't quite understand color spaces or ACES and want to know how to leverage those better in your workflows, check out this video that we made here for you. And if you're actually here from that video, stay tuned, we're jumping into what you want in just a second. Okay, so now that we're all on the same page about what ACES is and why it's important and how to set it all up and yada, 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 let's go ahead and dive in. So let's first explain why some of our assets are in Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4. A lot of our old assets were shot on DSM C2 body red cameras. You might recognize them as the big old chonky boys that are not quite as beautiful and sleek and nice as these new red cameras we see. But don't let the outdated appearance fool you, they are still incredible cameras. We chose Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4 for these assets because at the time, it provided the most data from these red cameras so that you guys wouldn't lose any data when it came to compositing. The issue is, Adobe just didn't want to play nice with a lot of these different color spaces. But we have a solution. I have to give a huge shout out to our friends over at Red for helping us develop the solution to this problem. They created LUTs specifically for us to give to you guys. And there's a link down in the description below where you guys can go and download those today. So let's go ahead and jump in.
Then go to Lumetri.
So we're now in After Effects and we're already set up to work inside of our ACES workflow. We already have a composition set up with a clip in it that's converted from the correct color space into ACES. So what we're going to do is grab one of our Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4 assets and drag it into our composition. If you're not sure of the color space that your asset is in, we put all of this information on our website on the actual product pages themselves. We do this so you can quickly reference and understand exactly what you're working with and how to get the best results out of it. So as you can see, our clip doesn't look quite right. Actually, it looks pretty bad. So what we're going to do is go back and find our clip within the project window. Right-click on it, go down to Interpret Footage, Main. Now we're going to go over to the Color tab. Next, we're going to click on the drop-down beside Override Media Color Space. We're going to scroll down until we find the option Input Red Input Red Linear Dragon Color 2. With just this selected, our fire still isn't going to look quite right. There's one more step. Now let's put Lumetri on our ActionVFX asset. Within Lumetri, under the basic corrections, you have an input LUT option. There are a couple different presets in here already, but these aren't what we're looking for.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
Here is where those LUTs from Red are going to come in handy. So what we need to do is let's actually back out and go to our file browser. Go ahead and pull up two file browser windows, one with the LUTs from Red that you just downloaded from our website, and on the other one, let's go to Local Disk, Program Files, Adobe, Adobe After Effects, Support Files, Lumetri, LUTs, and then Technical. These technical LUTs lay the foundation for any other Lumetri effects you apply afterwards. So it's important that we put them in here. Now that you've found where to put the LUTs, let's go back to our LUTs and find the one we need to bring over. Now that our asset wants to be in a linear gamma from the selection we made under interpretations, let's drag over the RG42LIN64.cube. This LUT will essentially transform this asset from its original gamma of red gamma 4 into linear so that our ACES transform is exactly what we want it to be. Now that we've done that, let's go back into After Effects. You're going to have to restart it. I recommend that you use this chance to go ahead and save your file, because if you're anything like me, you'd forget to save your file until Adobe does what Adobe does and it crashes on you and you lose all of that work and you hate your life. Now that our After Effects is booted back up again, let's go back to our asset and back to Lumetri. Under the basic correction, go to Input LUT, and now select the LUT we just moved over into the technical folder, RG42LIN64. And as you can see, now the asset looks so much better. And the best part is, whether you're in this project or in a new one, when you import a Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4 asset into your project, you'll do the imply interpretation, and then you'll add the Lumetri effect to it, and that LUT will always be there for you. You'll never have to select it from your file browser again. I hope you find this video useful and that it helps you when you're compositing your Dragon Color 2 Red Gamma 4 assets from ActionVFX into your scene. If you're not an ActionVFX user or subscriber, we recommend checking out our website. We have over 11,000 premium VFX assets for you, from rain and fire and smoke, fog, and muzzle flashes, anything you can think of. So if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and while you're at it, go ahead and hit that like as well. If you're feeling up to it, leave us a comment also. That's all we have for you today. Thanks for watching, and go make something cool.